Many sources of sound have certain frequencies of vibration that are determined entirely by their inherent properties, such as dimensions, the material they are made of, and shape. If set in vibration and left by itself, such a source will continue to vibrate freely and produce a tone of constant frequency which will gradually die away as the vibrating energy dissipates. For example, a tuning fork struck and left by itself, and a stretched string that is plucked. Are examples of free vibration. It's also possible to force a sound source to vibrate at frequencies not natural to it. For example, the tuning fork you just heard has a natural frequency of 433 cycles per second. We will now place an electromagnet between the prongs of the tuning fork and pass through the coils of the magnet an alternating current of some other frequency, say 428 cycles per second. That's the sound of the tuning fork vibrating at 428 cycles per second. What happens is this. The alternating current changes the magnetization of the magnetic core, which in turn alternately pulls on the prongs of the tuning fork at the same frequency as the current. So the fork, although it has a natural frequency of 433 cycles, is forced to vibrate at 428 cycles. Listen again as we switch the driving frequency on and off. You will hear the fork attempt to vibrate at its natural frequency. Then you will hear beats as the fork vibrates both at its natural frequency and the driven frequency. Then you will hear it settle down to vibrating only at the driven frequency. When we switch the current off, the fork is set free to vibrate at its natural frequency again. Now let's change the frequency of the current in the magnet gradually. First, we'll drive the fork at 420 cycles. As we increase the frequency of the current, the pitch of the tuning fork will also increase. Notice that as we near 433 cycles, the sound becomes louder. Then as we pass higher than 433, the sound becomes softer. That was an example of a phenomenon called resonance. When the forcing vibrations have the same frequency as the natural vibrations, they coincide and reinforce each other. Here's another example of resonance. We'll strike a tuning fork and hold it near another tuning fork that has the same natural frequency. Then we'll stop the first fork from vibrating. That's the sound of the second fork continuing to vibrate freely after being started in resonant vibration by the first fork.